Hello students, in the last two classes we learnt about factorization. I hope you understood the concept of factorization and you were able to do the assignment sums given to you. Okay, moving on to the next chapter, we are going to learn about expansions. You have learnt expansion in your standard 8. This year you will learn few more identities. You have learned I think around 10 identities. This year few more identities will be added, and with those identities you will be asked to solve the sums. Shall we start, children? Okay. Identities. Okay, we will recall the identities which you learn in the 8th standard. First one, a plus b the whole square, which is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. A minus b the whole square, a square plus b square minus 2ab. A square minus b square, which is equal to a minus b a plus b. A plus 1 by a the whole square, which is equal to a square plus 1 by a square plus 2. A minus 1 by a the whole square, which is equal to a square plus 1 by a square minus 2. Are you able to recall? Next, a plus b plus c the whole square, which is equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2 of ab plus bc plus ca. Or you can write it as a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. The next one is a minus b plus c the whole square, which is equal to a square plus b square plus c square minus 2ab minus 2bc plus 2ac. Coming to the cubes, you have learned about cubes also. A plus b the whole cube is equal to a cube plus b cube plus 3ab of a plus b. A minus b the whole cube is equal to a cube minus b cube minus 3ab of a minus b. A plus 1 by a the whole cube, which is equal to a cube plus 1 by a cube plus 3 of a plus 1 by a. A minus 1 by a the whole cube is equal to a cube minus 1 by a cube minus 3 of a minus 1 by a. Now I think you are able to recall these identities which you have learned last year. Okay, what new identities you are going to learn this year? That is a plus b the whole square plus a minus b the whole square is equal to 2 of a square plus b square. When you expand this, finally you arrive at 2 of a square plus b square. A plus b the whole square minus of a minus b the whole square is equal to 4ab. A plus 1 by a the whole square plus a minus 1 by a the whole square is equal to 2 of a square plus 1 by a square. A plus 1 by a the whole square minus of a minus 1 by a the whole square is equal to 4. So you should be knowing these 4 also. So make sure you learn these 4 identities apart from these 11 identities. Okay. Now to start with the sums, the problems based on the identities. Find the square. 7x by 8 plus 4 by 5y the whole square. You are supposed to square it. You will be using the identity a plus b the whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. Using the identity here, you will get 7 by 8x the whole square plus 4 by 5 the y the whole square plus 2ab. That will become 2 into 7x by 8 into 4y by 5. 7x the whole square will become 49x square upon 8 square is 64 plus 16y square by 25 plus, you get cancelled, so it is 7x by 5. Here 8, 4 2s are 8 and 8 and 8 gets cancelled. You get 7xy by 5. Okay. Next sum, 2x by 7 minus 7y by 4 the whole square. Now this is of the form a minus b the whole square. You know a square plus b square minus 2ab. Using this identity, we have to expand this. You get 2x by 7 the whole square plus 7y by 4 the whole square minus 2 into 2x by 7 into 7y by 4. Solving this, 2x the whole square is 4x square by 49 plus 49y square by 16 minus 7 and 7 gets cancelled. 2 2s are 4, that gets cancelled. You get minus xy. So this is the way you square using the identities. Going to the next sum. If a plus b is equal to 7, ab is equal to 10, you have to find a minus b. Now what is the identity which relates a plus b, a minus b and ab? Now you have learned the new identity, a plus b the whole square minus of a minus b the whole square, which is equal to 4. This is the new identity which you have learned. Using this identity and substituting the value, what is a plus b? That is 7. So this becomes 7 square minus of a minus b the whole square is equal to 4. Sorry, it is 4ab. So it will become 4 into 10. It is 49 minus of a minus b the whole square is equal to 40. 49 minus 40 is equal to a minus b the whole square. This is 9 is equal to a minus b the whole square. So a minus b will become equal to 9, square root of 9, which is equal to plus or minus 3. Whenever you find the square root, you have to use plus or minus, because the square root has always two values. One is positive, the other is negative. Moving on to the next sum, x plus y is equal to 7 by 2, xy is equal to 5 by 2. You have to find x minus y and x square minus y square. Now, what is the identity which relates x plus y, x minus y and xy? This is the same identity which you have learned. A plus b the whole square minus of a minus b the whole square is equal to 4ab. So this will become x plus y the whole square minus of x minus y the whole square is equal to 4xy. Substituting the values of x plus y and xy, we can find the value of x minus y. X plus y is 7 by 2 the whole square minus of x minus y the whole square is equal to 4 into 5 by 2. Your xy is 5 by 2. So this gets cancelled. This is 49 by 4 minus of x minus y the whole square is equal to 10. Transposing this here and getting 10 this side, you get 49 by 4 minus 10 is equal to x minus y the whole square. When minus of x minus y the whole square goes that side, it becomes plus. 49 minus 40 by 4 is equal to x minus y the whole square. This will give you 9 by 4 is equal to x minus y the whole square. So it is square root of 9 by 4 is equal to x minus y the whole square. Or you get x minus y is equal to plus or minus of 3 by 2. So you get x minus y is equal to plus or minus 3 by 2. I told you whenever you are finding the square root, henceforth you have to write plus or minus. Always the square root values are 2. One will be positive, the other one will be negative. So you get plus or minus 3 by 2. What's the next part? X square minus y square. How to find x square minus y square? X square minus y square is of the form a square minus b square, which is equal to a plus b, a minus b. So this can be written as x plus y, x minus y. Now what's the value of x plus y? Which is 7 by 2, and your x minus y is plus or minus 3 by 2, which will give you plus or minus 21 by 2. So here we are using the new identities which you have learned. A plus b the whole square minus of a minus b the whole square is equal to 4ab. Moving on to the next sum. A plus b is equal to 6. A minus b is equal to 4. You are supposed to find a square plus b square and ab. Now, what is the identity which relates a minus b, a plus b and a square plus b square? That is a plus b the whole square plus a minus b the whole square is equal to 2 of a square plus b square. You will use this identity. Substitute the values of a plus b. What is a plus b? It is 6. Plus a minus b the whole square is 4 square is equal to 2 of a square plus b square. 36 plus 16 equal to 2 of a square plus b square. So you get a square plus b square is equal to 52 by 2, which is equal to 26. So the value of a square plus b square is equal to 26. Now you have to find the value of AB. You will use the identity A plus B the whole square minus of A minus B the whole square is equal to 4AB. Here you have A plus B, you have A minus B, you can find AB. Two known and one unknown. Now what is A plus B? It is 6. So this becomes 6 square minus 4 the whole square is equal to 4ab. 36 minus 16 equal to 4ab, which is 20 by 4 is equal to ab, which will give you the value of ab as 5. So the value of ab is 5. The value of a square plus b square is equal to 26. So this is the way you have to use the new identity which you have learned this year. Shall we proceed? Here you have a plus 1 by a is equal to 6. You have to find a square plus 1 by a square, a minus 1 by a and a square minus 1 by a square. Now how to do this? A plus 1 by a is equal to 6. Now observe here, you have got a plus 1 by a is equal to 6. You have to find a square plus 1 by a square. So squaring both sides, you get a plus 1 by a the whole square is equal to 6 square. or it is when you expand a plus 1 by a the whole square, you get a square plus 1 by a square plus 2 is equal to 36. So a square plus 1 by a square is equal to 36 minus 2, or a square plus 1 by a square is equal to 34. So the first answer you got. What's the next thing you have to find? You have to find a minus 1 by a. How to find a minus 1 by a? You can use the new identity which you have learned, that is a plus 1 by a the whole square, a plus 1 by a the whole square minus of a minus 1 by a the whole square is equal to 4. So substituting the value of a plus 1 by a, which is 6. So 6 square minus of a minus 1 by a the whole square is equal to 4. 36. Transposing 4 to this side and minus a minus of minus 1 by a the whole square to the other side, you get 36 minus 4 is equal to a minus 1 by a the whole square, which is equal to 32, a minus 1 by a the whole square. So here you get a minus 1 by a the whole square is equal to 32, which is a minus 1 by a is equal to square root of 32. Now 32 can be written as the perfect square, 16 into 2. So what's the square root of 16? It is plus or minus 4 root 2. So you get a minus 1 by a is equal to plus or minus 4 root 2. The third one which you have to find is a square minus 1 by a square. A square minus 1 by a square. Now this is of the form a square minus b square, which is equal to a minus b, a plus b. So this will become a plus 1 by a of a minus 1 by a. Now what is a plus 1 by a? A plus 1 by a is 6. So you will substitute the value of a plus 1 by a as 6, and the value of a minus 1 by a is plus or minus of 4 root 2, which will give you plus or minus of 24 root 2. Whenever you are finding the square root, make sure to use plus or minus. Moving on to the next sum, a square minus 3a plus 1 equal to 0, and a is not equal to 0. Now here this is a quadratic equation. How to solve this? You have to find a plus 1 by a and a square plus 1 by a square. Now a square minus 3a plus 1 equal to 0. Now dividing by a throughout, that means you have to divide each term by a. Minus 3a by a plus 1 by a, 0 by a. So this gets cancelled, a and a gets cancelled. So what are you left with? A minus 3 plus 1 by a is equal to 0, or a plus 1 by a is equal to 3. Transposing minus 3 to the right hand side, it becomes plus 3. So you get the value of a plus 1 by a is equal to 3. So whenever you get a quadratic equation like this, you have to divide throughout by a and then arrive at the solution a plus 1 by a is equal to 3. Now how to find a square plus 1 by a square with this? Squaring both sides, you get a plus 1 by a the whole square is equal to 3 square. So when you expand it, you get a square plus 1 by a square plus 2 is equal to 9. So you get a square plus 1 by a square is equal to 9 minus 2. Transposing 2 to the right hand side, you get a square plus 1 by a square is equal to 7. So this is the way you have to find the value when the quadratic equation is given. Okay, now moving on to the next sum. 3x plus 4y is equal to 16. Okay, and you have got the value of xy is equal to 4, and you are supposed to find 9x square plus 16y square. So when do you get 9x square and 16y square from this expression? Only by squaring. So squaring both sides. You get 3x plus 4y the whole square is equal to 16 square. Make sure you square both the sides. Now here for expanding 3x plus 4y the whole square, you will be using a plus b the whole square, which is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. So you get 3x the whole square plus 4y the whole square plus 2 of 3x of 4y is equal to 256. 16 square is 256. 9x square plus 16y square plus 24xy is equal to 256. You know the value of xy, which is equal to 4. 9x square plus 16y square plus 24 of 4 equal to 256. 9x square plus 16y square plus 96 is equal to 256. 9x square plus 16y square is equal to 256 minus 96. Transposing 96 to the right hand side, you get 9x square plus 16y square is equal to 160. So this is the way you find the value of 9x square plus 16y square. Children, I hope you understood the new identities which you have learned. Once again, you can go through the new identities, which is a plus b the whole square plus a minus b the whole square is equal to 2 of a square plus b square. A plus b the whole square minus of a minus b the whole square is equal to 4ab. A plus 1 by a the whole square plus a minus 1 by a the whole square is equal to 2 of a square plus 1 by a square. A plus 1 by a the whole square minus of a minus 1 by a the whole square is equal to 4. You will be using these identities to solve the sums. I hope you understood. Now make a note of the assignment for today's class. This is your assignment. Thank you, children.